friend Harry Allick from England recently made a complete tutorial about long club stretches. And this is something that I got very excited about. You can see it on the website. I'll put the link below this video. And it really got me going about this. Now, I don't know how to use baseball bats. I've got my trusty first clubs here, which are CJ1s. They're 26 inches long, so they're long enough for this type of thing. And the whole idea of the long club stretches, which Harry was showing about basically lifting the clubs up, straightening out to the sides, to the top, forward, up, down, out. Great stretches. And now I thought, well, to myself, well, you know, when I first got these clubs, they are actually too long for me. I mean, they're really long, as you can see. They touch the top of my shoulders. So one of the biggest problems with them is that if you do standard heart shapes, and we all do heart shapes, parallels, or alternates, if we do the standard heart shape, the clubs are liable to crash at the back of the head. And Harry's idea brings something else forward completely. And one of the things that I do during my practice and training, because I consider the two basically linked, is that I train each individual circle that I know. Inward and outward, they're all done in the same way. And I came up with the idea that basically, if you swing two full circles, so straight arm circles, that means the arm and the club basically pivoting from the shoulder, and then allow one club to do a back circle. Okay, so there's only two circles involved here, two. And then do another full circle, and then do a back circle with the other side. So I'm just going to give you a demonstration, which is what you saw me do at the beginning. So here we go, starting from the Y position, swing through one to the top. When you reach to the top, as the clubs start coming out, one comes down, second, one comes to the back. So that's the complete sequence. So that's four. One, two, three, four. Two big circles, one big circle, one small circle at the back. Two big circles again, and one small circle and big circle on the other side. So it's reversed. Okay, so let's just go through that again. Starting from the starting position, Y position, one, two, three, four. And it really helps if you count. So now, if you're struggling with this, because there is a little bit of coordination here, because if you think about it, the large circle, the straight arm circle, is the fastest Indian club circle. This one is the slowest. And you have to turn, when you turn the two together, you have to slow down the small circle to keep time with the big circle. So if I do here, one. And they have to both come up together. So you can see that my right arm is moving a lot faster, one. And they meet up at the top. And if you do the other side, they start from the top, and they meet back up at the top. So how do you practice it? First of all, you can start by just practicing circles. So one, two, three, four. Okay. Now, you can't do this at the back. So I suggest that you practice a back circle, remembering to move your elbow and open your elbow out to the side, because we want that club to be traveling in a flat line. Do the same on the other side. And then to break into it, you can do one, two, one, two, before you do them together. One, two, one, two. So now to carry on, if you're wanting to work on this a little bit more, there's another way of looking at it too. starting with the clubs at the top, we're going to do only the back circle on the right side. So one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. And then do it on the left. One, two, one. Whoops, made a mistake, sorry. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Now, I don't know if you've noticed, but just to give you a little bit of a tip, that when I'm going into the back circle, this club has to come in on the inside. So there's the circle. It clears, watch, from the side. One, two, one, two. So the hands are not changing front to back. Same happens on the right hand side. So with the circle, the right will come on the inside. One, two, one. Slide the club down. Two, one, two, one, two. And when you've practiced that a bit, give it a go. You could do two, two on each side until you get to the point where mentally you can do alternates, which is again, two front circles, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now, as you saw in the demonstration that I did at the beginning, you can apply this method to parallels. So you're doing the circles to the side, and then you're doing an inward and an outward circle. Then you're doing them inward, and then you're doing them parallels to the left. So you can do that. But if you can get this first section through, then and start practicing that, then that'll be great. Because in the following videos I'm going to do, because this will be a little series, then we're going to go into, so from the back circle, we're going to transfer into the wrist circle here, which means that the arm has to be straight. And just to give you an idea, I'll show you. The wrist circles I'm talking about are here, there. Not here, not with a bent arm, they're straight. So I'll show you in the next video how to do that one. Now this whole series actually is a series of 64 movements. 32 of them are the double circles, and in between each double circle you're doing a smaller circle. So it's a question of timing. So have a go, have a work on it, and just enjoy it, because it's great fun to do, and it just gives you that something a bit different from heart shapes and parallels. It's something new. And be prepared to make mistakes. And I'm just going to show you now. I'm going to do some of the other more advanced stuff. And you'll probably see me make a complete stuff up, because I'm still learning how to do it. But I want you to be aware of the fact that, I mean, it's something that we all do. We all have to learn. So here we go.
Inward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
So as you can see, with some of the circles, the ones that are giving me the most problem at the moment is the timing of the big circle and the one on across here, as you can probably see in there when I was doing it. It's very hard. I've got my hands around the wrong way and I get stuck. So I mean, I just wanted to show you, I mean, I'm still making mistakes with this, and I mean, we all expect to make mistakes. In fact, I cherish them because I study my mistakes very, very carefully. And what I was talking to you about earlier on, with when you're going into the circle from here, just into the back circle, this arm, if I do the back circle of my right hand, this hand has to come underneath, because look, see, this one clears out of the way, and then you can do this. One, two. So, again, I'll do a video on the wrist circle, and then I'll do a circle on the front wrist circle, which is this one here or there. And then I'll do one on the back circle and how to put them all together. And I just think it's a lovely exercise. And again, Harry, Allick, thank you so much, because it's been so inspiring watching your videos, and it's just made me think of swinging long clubs in a different way, so that you do not get this situation when you come over, bang, and they crash at the back. So once again, Harry, that's a great idea. Thank you very much. And I hope you all enjoyed this. If you're new and watching this, go to my website, www.indianclubs.com. Indianclubsacademy.com. You can get a free 6-part video session there on learning how to do the front and the back circle, which is very much part of what I've just done here. And to all of you, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care. And just finally, if you have any comments or things you wanna say or ask me, if I can help in any way, please make a comment below the video or on the webpage, on the blog post, and I'll try and answer you as soon as I can.